Hello friends, welcome to my channel Skill on Tech. In this video we shall discuss about working principle of centrifugal pump. As you know, centrifugal pumps are widely used in industries for process flow. Freshers and engineering students of chemical and mechanical branch know about this. Video become very interesting. Hence, please see the complete video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel and share video with your friends and colleagues. Let us know what is centrifugal force. You can see a picture where a person is rotating a stone with a string. Two forces are seen, centrifugal force, centripetal force. So what is this? When a disc is rotated holding a string by a person, a force is created outside of center of disc along radius is called centrifugal force. The same is shown in the figure. The force which acts along the radius towards center is called centripetal force. So what is centrifugal force? Centrifugal force can be calculated using force equal to m omega square r mass into acceleration, where omega is equal to angular velocity, r is a radius and m is a mass. Let us see a general construction of a centrifugal pump casing. Two diagrams of centrifugal pump casing are shown in the slide. You can see inlet of the pump. So this is inlet of the pump. The water enters into the suction at the center of the impeller. Outlet for outgoing fluid means discharge. So this is discharge. Impeller. This is impeller. This rotating assembly is impeller. So here are curved vanes. Curved vanes are shown in the picture. So impeller, what it does? Rotor assembly transferring energy to fluid, imparting centrifugal force to incoming fluid at center. So this impeller, which is driven by a electric motor, is rotating and having kinetic energy. So that kinetic energy of impeller is transferred to incoming fluid, which is coming in the center of the impeller. Volute. This is a volute casing. You can see this area of a volute casing, which is going increasing. Equations. Let us understand how pressure is rise in the discharge of a pump with the simple equations of a Bernoulli principle. So what is Bernoulli continuity equation? A1 V1 equal to A2 V2. A1 is the area, V1 is the initial velocity, and A2 is the discharge area, and V2 is the discharge velocity. Where A is here in this equation, A denotes a cross-sectional area and V is the velocity. So what is Bernoulli equation? The energy in the liquid, P plus half mv square plus mgh. P is a pressure energy, half mv square is a kinetic energy, and mgh is a potential energy equal to constant. So this energy remains constant at two points of a flowing liquid. So this is applied in a centrifugal pump at suction and discharge. Now we will see how a pressure generation occurs in the centrifugal pump. So let us see a picture of a impeller and a volute casing. This is impeller and this is a volute casing. The kinetic energy of impeller is transmitted to fluid through its curved vanes. So these are the curved vanes which transmit kinetic energy to fluid. Fluid experiences centrifugal force outwards of the center and is guided through volute towards discharge. So this is a volute casing. The area of this volute is getting increased. You can see in the picture. As distance between impeller and volute increases, so here the area of volute is increasing. And we can apply a continuity equation here. Area is less, kinetic energy is more. Area is increases, kinetic energy is less and potential energy is more. So pressure is increasing here. As fluid loses kinetic energy, it gains to hold pressure energy as per Bernoulli equation. So here at the discharge of this point, it will regain pressure. So pressure energy will be the highest at the discharge. There may be some losses inside of this. So while applying Bernoulli equation, we should calculate the losses also, add losses. So what is the relation between head or pressure? Head is a measurement of the height of the liquid column the pump could create from the kinetic energy the pump gives to the liquid. Head can be converted to pressure using Bernoulli equation. So here we can see with this equation, head equal to P2 minus P1 upon rho g plus P2 square upon 2g, where P2 and P1 are outlet and inlet pressures respectively, and V2 is outlet velocity. Head is used instead of pressure to measure a centrifugal pump energy, as pressure from pump will change if the specific gravity weight of the liquid changes, but the head will not change. So at the discharge of pump, head is measured. That is all for this video. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, please hit the like button below and share with your friends and colleagues. Please leave your questions, comments and feedback in section below. Thank you.